In this video, I'll show you how to make a simple rectangular box that's got some mitered corners on it. So we'll start a new part. Make sure your sheet metal tab is active. If it's not, just right click, put a check mark by it. Excuse me, go to sheet metal, base flange tab, choose a plane. So I'll sketch out the base of this box, which is 8" by 4" rectangle. And before you get out, let's make sure you set the sheet metal thickness. In this case, we're going to use 0.065. These values can stay at the default values. There's the bottom. We're going to add some sides, so we'll use under sheet metal, we'll put in the edge flanges, and we're going to select our edges where we want to add the flange. I'm going to pull it out toward me and click it. Come over here and set the actual distance, and it's going to be 2". And I'll leave these all on the default setting. I am going to change this bend radius to 60 thousandths instead of 30 thousandths. And if I'm happy with all that, I'll just continue on with my other edges, pull them toward me to get my flanges on there, and everything is good. Say okay. And there's my box. I'm going to add these top pieces now. So again, under sheet metal tab, edge flange. Click on this edge. I'm going to pull it toward me and set that dimension at 0.75. And I'm going to leave all the default settings on. So notice what I'm doing with, because I've got the position there on the inside. I'm maintaining my overall dimensions that I started with, which was 8 by 4 by 2. Okay, so we want our other, get back over here, get my other edges on there. As long as this is blue is active, then I can continue. Oh, I do want to change the bend radius on those as well. That's 60 thousandths too. As long as that blue is highlighted, then you can keep clicking on edges, pull it toward you, and you see what's going to happen. The software is going to automatically create mitered corners unless you do some action to change that. And I'm going to make all these corners mitered corners, same dimension, same bend radius. Say okay. So there's my simple box. I do want to add some holes on there. In this case, I'll just use the sketch and extrude cut, just like we've always done. So choose a plane, put my holes in here. And those are all 3/16. I'm just going to make them all equal. So one dimension will control all four holes, basically. So if you decide to change that, so if you just say equal, they're all 3/16. And I do need location dimensions for those holes. And everything is 0.25. Oop, got the wrong thing there. Let's keep dimensioning here. Finish the sketch, use extrude cut, we'll cut our holes. Okay, so there's our box with the holes in it. I'm going to go ahead and save that. And we'll put that on a drawing sheet. So we have several options here on the drawing sheet, and that is depends on what you're trying to present. If someone was going to make this manually, then you want to make sure you put all your details on there. And let's go ahead and put all the details on. So we'll do our three typical views, and we'll do an ISO. I'm going to slide these over. Let's go back to our part for a minute. Let's look at the flat pattern. So if you click on sheet metal and go to flatten, you can see what the flat pattern looks like. And that's a pretty valuable piece of information. You could take that and make a DXF file with it, send it to your CNC plasma, laser, water jet machine, etc. Or you can manually. Sometimes what people do is print these out full size and just use them as a pattern to manually cut this stuff out. Okay, so that's what that looks like. We're going to try to put that on the same sheet. I think we can fit this all on here. It's kind of a lot. Typically you wouldn't do that, but let's just keep it simple here. One of my views is going to be the flat pattern. There it is. I'll drag it out here. And it's going to try to show you the thickness of the metal, but I don't want to see the thickness of the metal. So let's see if we can sneak all this on here. Luckily, we don't have a lot of dimensions. And you'll see on your flat pattern, it shows the shape and location and where the bends are. It tells you the angles, and it also tells you the bend radius. So you could put dimensions. If you're manually going to make this, you could put the dimensions on there. Let's just put some overall dimensions on the box itself. Let's see, that's not one of them. Ha, the computer's kind of jumping around today. Like I have too much stuff open right now. So general size, one thing you'll want to do is put a note on there that calls out the thickness. I do need to dimension the locations on those, the size and location on those holes too. Let's zoom in a little bit. We'll do 4x on that. Mention this in over here. Oh, and I think that's it, right? We just need to call it the thickness of the metal then. So we will just use a note here, call out the material. It's 0.065 1018 cold roll steel. And it should be all the information you need. You might call out a bend radius, but those are called out on the flat pattern. So that makes a nice, concise drawing. I think I got everything covered, so that's pretty much how you're going to do that.